Hey everybody, it's Brian Beacoff. Welcome to another episode of True Story. This is a good one. Okay, so this was many years ago. I was living in an apartment in Los Angeles. I was working at Universal Studios. It was a really cool apartment. In fact, I've done this several times in my apartments, but I've refinished my hardwood floors like I would have carpet in my apartment, but I knew that there was hardwood underneath the carpet, so I paid for, out of my own pocket, to redo the hardwood floors. I knew how to do it, and huge expense for an apartment that I was renting, but I really liked hardwood floor. Anyway, there was a fire. An explosion, really. That's another story. I had to move out of the apartment, and other people had to move out of the apartment, not because of me. I had the option of moving into an apartment next door, right? They said it was a little bigger, the floors were nicer because they were already finished. So after I moved back into my apartment, they cleared out the smoke and all that stuff. And one night I was in bed and I'm thinking, man, I really want to know what that apartment next door looks like. And the people had since moved out. And I'd never seen it before. I'm laying in bed. I'm like, gosh, I don't want to agree to moving into that apartment without seeing it. And there was some reason why I needed to make a decision or something like that. Like I wasn't able to see the apartment. They're old like bungalows, you know, from the like the 40s, the 30s or the 40s. And we had an attic, or I had an attic, but every apartment had an attic. And I had stuff up there. So I knew that I could access the attic with a step stool and everything and kind of like shimmy myself up into the attic in the bedroom, all my Christmas decorations and all that stuff. Get out of bed, bring my chair, open up my attic, and I shimmy up into the attic. Now, only up until this time, I had only like put boxes, you know, from the attic hole in the bedroom. I'd only like placed my Christmas boxes so they were within reach, etc. But this time, I hoisted myself up into the attic. I don't know if you've ever been in an attic before, but there's the beams and there's the insulation and all that stuff. So you gotta be careful where you stand, first of all, because you don't wanna like go right through the floor. I'm gonna go into that other apartment. I'm gonna take a look. I'm gonna see if I like it. I'm gonna tell my landlord tomorrow that, yeah, I wanna move into that apartment. Going across the beam. I don't know if I had a flashlight or my phone. I don't know. I don't think the phones had flashlights then. I don't know. I'm telling you this story and I'm already thinking like, this is just so stupid. Going across the beams, you know, stepping across the beams, you know, not to step through the sheetrock in the ceiling into the floor. And I find the hole, it's kind of in the same place as my bedroom, and I lift it up. It's dark, but I know that the people just moved out and the power hasn't been turned off yet, so I know I can turn on the lights, which is great. I kind of like get myself to my elbows, are kind of like propping myself down on either side of the hole. It wasn't too big, you know? I'm like swinging, my legs are swinging into these people's apartment, empty. Swinging, and then I'm able to drop down. It wasn't too high, like I wasn't afraid of like breaking my ankle or my leg or anything like that. Drop down, I'm like, okay. And I listen, because there's neighbors on either side of that apartment. One is me and one's someone else. So I gotta make sure that, you know, they knew that people had moved out. You know, who's in that apartment? I find the lights, and that's already sketchy, like turning on the lights in case the neighbors saw or they drove up or whatever. So I'm like, oh, this is great. These floors are beautiful. It's not much bigger than the apartment that I had, but whatever. And plus the apartment that I had still had, you know, smoke damage after I'd finished all the floors. Oh, this is great. I think I'm gonna do it. I think I'm gonna move into this apartment. How do I get back? How do I get back up into that hole? So, I'm looking for a chair. Everyone's moved out, there's no chair. So, trying to jump, can't get up there. Can't get up, so I'm like, okay, well, I will turn off the lights and I will go through, you know, the back door and back to the apartment. I go to the back door, bolted. So this is dangerous. Have you ever lived in a house like this where there's a key with a bolt on either side? So like, if you don't have your key, how do you get out the back door? That's how it was. So I'm like, oh, this is bad. Am I locked in this apartment? I'm gonna have to like bust through the window. I go to the front door, unlock from inside, thank goodness, and turn the bottom lock so I can close the door. Maybe they'll forget that they had bolted it. I turn off the lights and I sneak through the front door and close it. Okay, great. Breaking and entering? Yeah, probably, whatever. Hi. Well, this is good. I'm glad I did this. It's 3 a.m. I'm in my pajamas. I don't know what I was thinking. Walk back to my apartment, door locked, no keys. Locked out. Oh my God, well I'm gonna try to go back into that other, locked out. Didn't have my phone. No keys. Oh, right. I know what I did. Okay. It's 3 a.m. It's freezing cold. I'm in my pajamas. I'm glad I was in my pajamas. Like, what if I was like, hey, I'm just going to go do this in my underwear or whatever. My bathroom window was a little sketch. It's an older building. Even though there were newer windows in the bathroom, I was kind of able to like shimmy it. And it was a tough climb. The house was on a foundation. I think I had to shimmy some boxes or some crates, some vegetable crates, to get up to my bathroom window and then shimmy myself into the bathtub where I fell with a clunk. I think I cut up, I'm always hurting myself doing these things. Cut up my chest, not on glass or anything, but just on scraping the windowsill coming in. The next morning I thought about it and I decided to stay in my apartment. It's kind of not a great ending to the story. It's dramatic. Anyway, it was still funny. Come on, I got locked out because I broke into someone else's apartment. I'll tell you about the fire next time. Bye.